Hey everybody, this is Coburn C, Capshaw, slash Mr. Smiles a Lot, and I am now going to be doing videos where I talk about my instructional videos that I've been taking notes on through Udemy, and thanks to my investor Alex Petro. These are videos for him. I end up posting these, I might not, but these are for work. But also, if he lets me post them, it'd be fun, because I will be able to show you different ways that these editing skills from these courses have actually corresponded to what I do for work right now, which I think is very beneficial, because I already did know a lot, but because of what I'm doing now, because of these courses, I'm learning a lot more. And it's so funny how, as I'm doing these courses, I realize that I'm already doing half the things that's already in here that didn't come to fruition until I started getting more technical with it. You will be able to see here over to my side in my advice video where I talk about Miles Morales and the video game review of Miles Morales. I am now going to relate that video to these course notes here from 1 to 9, then from 9 to 15. I'm going to show you a video of my father-in-law, and he's going to show you how to remove a stock oil dipstick to help relate to the notes, to also show you that these notes do relate to what I've already been doing for work. So, this course so far is going to help me better my video skills in areas that I am already familiar with, which is true. Number two, whether you have a nice camera or a smartphone, which as you all know, I do everything for my smartphone, but I love the quality, you can still make great videos. Every single edit that you see is from my smartphone. Every single thing that I do, you see is from my smartphone, which to me, I'm glad that I found the right apps that has helped me in my business so far and everything that I do and the way I market myself. Number three, always have a good story that is going to captivate your audience. Just like you see here in the advice video, in the gaming review, or anytime I do my martial arts videos or workout videos. I love doing those because I feel like that helps captivate people, and I really appreciate those who watch, and that's a good example of how to captivate your audience, in my opinion. So ask yourself, why are you making this video? That is also a very important question, and I had to come to terms with the fact that I love making advice videos because not only does it make me feel good, but I want everyone else to feel good as well. And I want them to know that I'm out there to help them if they need it. Number five is try to connect with the viewers through your story, which is what I always try to do in my advice videos, since as you can see over here on the side. Six, make sure you have enough light to help expose the image you want for your video example, artificial light or daylight. As you can see, you have an artificial light because the daylight outside does not help me. But a good example is whenever I do my training sessions with Justin and we're outside and we use the sun and we use the natural light from that. If I'm not using an artificial light right here, just like my ESDDI light, studio light, if you will. Having good lighting can also help tell your story, which is also true. Besides this, if it wasn't for my green screen and my lights, or if it wasn't for some of the lighting that I use here, even just my ceiling light or my kitchen light, that wouldn't help me tell my story, or any time I'm in different environments doing different videos for certain things, or just posts in general, the lighting of where I am makes the biggest difference ever. And I can definitely tell as an editor and as a marketer and a videographer myself. Light can also affect the mood of your video, which is obviously also true. So as you can see here in my advice video on the left, I chose the background of Miles Morales where it's kind of a darker background because of the fact I think it kind of hones you in more, kind of tells like the story better. You know, I just feel like it relates more, and I'm not saying that a bright background wouldn't look well, but I feel like a darker background to me looks more professional. Audio is very important. Some people forget how important this step is, hence why I'm now using my Saramonic boom microphone instead of my lavalier, because of the fact that I can tell how much it picks up in my voice, and you know, for my podcast, you all could probably tell as well. So, from 9 to 15, in this video here on the left now, as you can see, my father-in-law is showing you how to fix an oil dipstick. So, for example, you want a nice and clear voice during interview. versus dialogue between two characters. So even though that he was just talking, just like how I try to do, he is talking directly to the camera. So in a way, he's trying to talk to you and me at the same time. So that's interaction between two characters, even if it's not exactly an interview in a way. Don't forget about sound effects, voiceover, and music. So when I edit this video for him, I did not add any music. I upped his voice, the volume. I edited his voice to be up a little bit more so you could hear him better. And there's no sound effects. The effect, I guess you could say, that I did was put the little title screen about what he does and then make it disappear through my editing. Well, speaking of which, next step is editing or post-production, which is exactly what I did. So he gave me his video. And then when I was watching it, I added the filter. I cut out a little pieces here and there to make it shorter, make it a little more professional. And then, like I said, I edited his volume on his voice. And then I also added the title of what he's doing, and that was about it. Editing is more than putting together your best shots. So that is true. You have no idea how many times I'll have an extremely long video, and then I will have to cut it down to where it's like 12 minutes, but in reality it could be like 2 hours. It's about adding emotion or even comedy, adding color grading. So that's why my advice videos and everything you do, I can, or my podcast, I'm kind of my silly self even when I try to act professional. That's emotion, that's the comedy of the way, and color grading. That can go into a multitude of things, whether that's your background, your green screen, your backdrop, what have you, just anything that you do in your editing settings. And then number 15, finally, it's ultimately about putting your story together and getting it ready to show the world. So that's exactly why, as you can see, people like I and people in our field or business of being editors, videographers, and photographers of that nature, that's why we take the time to edit and do all these other things, as you see from my notes here, because of the fact of we want to give you everything that we can to the best of our ability. Is everything perfect? No. But that's why we try our best, and that's all we can really do these days. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Alex, I really hope you appreciate this. See you guys later.